John chapter 17, as well as in other places, that it would be our love for one another that would convince the world that he truly was the Messiah, that he was supernaturally sent by God, the creator of the universe, into this earth to be the savior of mankind. They would know it by our love. They wouldn't know it because of miracles. They wouldn't know it because of how well we could speak or how well off in comparison to others maybe we might be doing. Because sometimes we're doing a lot worse than other people by worldly standards. But they would know it by the distinctive of our love for one another. And obviously, as I've said two or three times, when you look around the world, there's no church that's known for that distinctive. There's churches that are known for being spirit-filled, churches that are known for being the prayer church, the worship church, the prophetic church, the church where everybody, you know, studies the Greek and the Hebrew. But there really isn't a church, especially in America, that's just known because it's been marked by the way the people in it love each other. And if we could become anything, that's such a high request to make. I think it's the greatest thing that we could ask God, that if we could ever become a church that was known for the way that we love each other, that would be amazing, wouldn't that? I mean, for people to one day just say, not because we have it on a sign somewhere in a slogan, but because of a real experience that they've had or something they've heard about, that is a place where they love each other. And I don't mean that false love where nobody ever gets in a fight, nobody ever argues, where a church doesn't deal with sin and have to discipline people, but I mean real love like you see in a family, where there is challenge and difficulty and at times argument and discipline, but they stick together and they continue through thick and thin to be there for one another. This is what Paul says the community of Christianity should be.